All right, first things first. We gotta correct a little misunderstanding that some normies have about Bitcoin out there. Because a lot of people have this idea because they see in the news, you know, people are talking about, oh man, someone, Bitcoin could be used for illegal stuff, and maybe someone bought drugs with this stuff, and blah, 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 it's on the dark web and all this kind of stuff. A lot of people have misunderstandings about Bitcoin. They have this idea that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are some kind of privacy tool, okay? They have this idea that if you do stuff in Bitcoin, no one knows about it. I just want to make something like abundantly clear, because I know there are a lot of people even who own Bitcoin who do not know this, or maybe they know it but they don't think it through. If you ever do anything illegal, or just not even illegal, but something you don't want people to know about in Bitcoin, you are an absolute irredeemable moron, okay? And that is because Bitcoin, of course, as a cryptocurrency, the crypto in cryptocurrency has nothing to do with it being like cryptic or hidden or anything like that. It has to do with the cryptographic nature of Bitcoin. Okay, Bitcoin is based on a blockchain. A blockchain is a public ledger of every single transaction in that currency, which by definition means that every person knows exactly how much every wallet holds, everyone that wallet has transacted with, where money is moved, where you got your money, everything, okay? All of that is public information. So unless you are doing extreme privacy mitigation methods to keep that information away from people or to obfuscate the blockchain, you are an idiot if you ever think that you are doing something private with Bitcoin. Bitcoin is honestly like the government's wet dream of currencies, because it's like a perfect... like, so much money is in it now, and a lot of people have these false impressions that it's like some kind of privacy currency, when in reality, it is literally the worst thing. Like, when you use a credit card or a debit card, at least only your credit card company knows about that, knows what you're spending it on. But in the case of in Bitcoin, anyone in the world can look up exactly what you're spending, how much you have, and where, okay? That is the easiest thing to do. Okay, so... why do I bring this up? Now, a lot of people have this idea, I care a lot about privacy, dude, I love privacy. I'm not, like, privacy to me, there's a personal side to privacy, and there's a systemic side to privacy. And in Bitcoin, like, I'm never gonna buy anything illegal, okay, with, like, cryptocurrencies. I have no desire, there's nothing illegal I can even think of that I want. There are reasons you still wanna use a coin, and there are cryptocurrencies out there that are actually private. The biggest one nowadays is Monero, okay? And I think there's a reason long-term that Bitcoin cannot be, it might be an investment or something, but I do not think that Bitcoin will become a like generally used private or like generally used currency out there, because it has this huge flaw. It's not the personal privacy issue, it's the systemic privacy. What do I mean by that? As it is right now, since the government can monitor all of your transactions, even if we're all doing things that are 100% legal, here's what happens. You buy Bitcoin, you get taxed. You trade Bitcoin to Ethereum, you get taxed. You trade to another cryptocurrency, you get taxed. You buy something from someone else, hey, you can get sales taxed on that. And you get taxed again every time you transact, you get taxed. And then when you transfer that into like American dollars, well, you got to pay capital gains tax, right? Everything is taxation and regulation. Governments are now starting to talk about making it illegal to have private like cold wallets, which is like absurd. Like, that's the basic functionality of, you know, having your private key. That's like the basic functionality of the blockchain. It's unregulatable. Like, you can't enforce that. But they're trying to do it. They want everyone using centralized exchanges where like every transaction is directly tied to an identity, because that makes the monitoring as easy as possible. They can regulate everything to hell, and they will, because these people who are regulating Bitcoin, they are boomers who do not understand the technology at all. And they just, I don't know, maybe they get scared by their own propaganda. Oh, people are using it for like drugs or something like that. So, you know, they scare themselves into doing all this crazy kind of stuff. So here's what I recommend to people. There are privacy coins out there like Monero, okay, being the biggest one. And what Monero does, it has a publicly auditable blockchain, but the difference is it has some very clever technology, actually. You can look up, they have little cutesy videos on it if you're interested. But they have ways of mitigating or really preventing people from actually tracing transactions. That is, people don't actually send money to your address. They actually create a stealth address that only you know that you have access to. So instead of having one wallet, you actually have a distributed set of wallets from where you got transactions, all of which only you know that you have. So no one looking at the blockchain knows how much money you have, whereas that is the case in Bitcoin. They know exactly how much money you have. And transactions on Monero, they're signed with ring signatures. You and other people will sign your transactions, so it's unclear who those transactions come from. Okay, so Monero, what's the advantage of this? Now, again, you might be one of those kind of people, I don't care about privacy, dude. But everyone actually does care about privacy. It's just like a cope that people say this kind of stupid stuff. Oh, I don't care about privacy. But in the case of Monero, if you're swinging, if you're buying stuff on Monero, no government could possibly charge you sales tax for that because they don't know that that's you transacting. They see some kind of transaction. They have no idea which of the people in the ring signature that was actually doing that and for how much and stuff like this. So everything is just like unclear, right? So Monero, although it has these privacy benefits, and you might not feel like you benefit from the personal privacy benefits, you might not care about your personal privacy, but you have systemic privacy in that regulating a currency like that, taxing it, and watching transactions, that is something that's basically impossible to do. Or if it is, there are some people who try to statistically model where transactions are or who this might be, but it's a big affair, right? And it's a big game. It's something that can't be cracked, right? So this is why long term, I think when we look into the future, of the hundreds of different countries out there, so many of them are going to be regulating Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies in just arbitrary and stupid ways. And the way of surviving that is not fighting it legally, but it's having a cryptocurrency that is immune to that kind of regulation. And Monero and other privacy coins, they are sort of, they're like that, okay? Now, right now, Monero actually, if you look at all the cryptocurrencies out there, as I'm speaking right now, February 2021, there's a big bull run going on in cryptocurrencies, everything's going up, but Monero has actually been very stable. It hasn't actually been going up. So you might, that doesn't seem like a good investment. Well, to me, it's not about, it's not necessarily about the dollar value of it, but long-term, I view this kind of technology, a lot of normies out there, here's the reality. Again, they have that misunderstanding I brought up at the beginning. They think that Bitcoin is private. It isn't, okay? Monero is what people think Bitcoin is, okay? And if they knew that, I think a lot of normies would immediately jump over to Monero. It's just like disinformation. They don't really know that kind of stuff. But, I view it, as governments regulate cryptocurrency more and more, the winners are going to be cryptocurrencies that are built in such a way to not be regulated, that they can't be watched, they can't be monitored. And even if you're someone like me, like, I don't really care that much about privacy. I mean, if I had a lot of, cryptocurrency and something that could be easily monitored, I wouldn't feel weird about spending it or people knowing how much I spend or use. But long term, the systemic privacy is more important. The fact that governments cannot regulate Monero in the way that they can regulate other cryptocurrencies, I think that's a lot more important. And I think as time goes on and they try and regulate more and more, I think you're just going to have those more private currencies are going to be proven superior, and they're going to last because they are built in a way to survive all that kind of stuff. And frankly, when it comes down to it, like, it's just absurd that people are using, people are basically using Bitcoin as an investment. Of course, nowadays you can buy a lot of stuff with Bitcoin. Nearly anything online you can buy with Bitcoin one way or another. But, I do feel that, like, I don't know if normies would be really comfortable using a currency where anyone can just, like, see their balance at any point in time or see everything they've, spent on. I feel like normies would feel weird about that kind of stuff. But so that's another reason I'm sort of bullish, if you please, on privacy coins. Anyway, so that's it. See you guys next time.